roast beef.
All right, welcome to Roast Beef, episode 7. We're out here at Hollywood High School, Cali style, and we got today
Norman Woods.
Gonna shred it up, and then we're gonna get our grub on.
In Napoli, where love is king, when boy meets girl, here's what they say.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing the tabella. Hearts will play, tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a guitarandella. When the stars make you drool, just like a pastifazool, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love. When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
All right, Norman, where we at?
At Vito's over on La Cienega, my favorite spot to eat.
Eat what?
Pizza.
Nice.
Always pizza when I come here. I mean, they have other things, but LA has so much terrible pizza that when I found this place, actual decent pizza, great pizza, I was like, yeah. So if I come here, I'm getting pizza.
Nice.
Fresh mozzarella slice.
I can't wait to try it. Yeah, Megan. What are you gonna get? I'll see what you get first.
I'll have a fresh mozzarella and a Garibaldi slice.
Yeah, great.
Do you have anchovies here?
We do.
Oh, sick. All right, I'm gonna get two slices.
Two? Okay.
Yes. One pepperoni, uh-huh. Jalapenos, uh-huh. And the other one anchovies, please.
Just anchovies?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll take. Cool.
So how'd you find out about this place?
I'm not even sure. I've been coming here for so long that I don't even remember. Like, I shouted this place out in my trans world checkout. And that was like 7 years ago.
7 years ago.
Yeah, that's so, and even by then, I've been coming here for a while. So
it must be good because it's still here.
Yeah. Well, now they got other locations. It used to be just this one.
Four.
Santa Monica.
Vito's
blowing.
LA.
Yeah. It's great pizza.
Shit, bro.
You can't get better pizza in California.
So I'm originally from Jersey.
Yeah. Oh,
and,
yeah.
And my family and I used to go to New York every weekend almost. So I grew up on New York style pizza.
And Jersey pizza's good too.
Bro. Oh, yeah. Just, yeah, right next door. Yeah.
Really
yeah. So I can't wait to try this, dude. I can't wait to try this nice pizza. I love New York pizza.
I think you'll enjoy it.
You like New York slices better than Chicago or what?
Deep dish
or you go slice?
I like New York better. I like Chicago pizza. But my favorite Chicago pizza is not even traditional Chicago style. It's like like that lasagna pizza.
The deep dish.
Like the, no, it's not even deep dish. It's like lasagna style pizza.
Wow.
What's the name of the place? No, it's layered. It's like they have them in Chicago and they have them in Florida also. And I'm spazzing on the name right now.
Is that something new?
No, it's not new because I found that place when I went out there to skate. No. It's actual lasagna pizza.
What?
There's a place that's called.
Yeah. Is there pizza crust around a lasagna or something?
No, it's pizza that's layered. It's about this thick.
Oh, dang.
You eat a slice of it. Yeah, look it up right now. Look it up, Chicago lasagna pizza.
It doesn't have a pizza crust.
It's called pizza lasagna.
Is there pizza crust on it too?
It's got a pizza crust on it. Yeah.
That must be like heavy.
Deep dish pizza.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
my favorite Chicago
pizza.
What's
it say?
What's deep dish.
But there's a place that's famous for it, and that's where I went to get it.
In Chicago?
Yeah, in Chicago. When I, like, I skated the King of Chicago contest, and somebody from there turned us
apparently
on.
Apparently everybody in Chicago makes it.
It's pretty amazing.
Oh, nice.
Pretty amazing.
So you said there's one in Florida, too?
Yeah, there's, well, the spot where I got it from that everyone raved about, there's one in Florida too. I just can't remember the name right now.
Is it right by Tampa?
Huh?
Is it right by Tampa?
Yeah.
Oh, we gotta hit that up.
Get that up.
Hey, we have to do that another roast beef out there.
Let's do it.
You know? Yeah. Let's
do it.
Cheers to that one. Nice.
You gonna go?
I'm gonna go to Phoenix Anderson. I'll take Carlos on.
Carlos should skate some contests for sure. Carlos rips.
So what do you usually get when you come to Vito's?
Fresh mozzarella slice.
That's your go-to after skating?
I usually get two. I wing it on the other one, but always a fresh mozzarella.
You said something else. You said you ordered
Garibaldi
slice.
Yeah,
what is that's like a fish that I know.
No, it's got like...
that's a California state fish though,
like,
right?
Yeah, but it's got like meatball and I forget what else.
Jalapeno.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Nice.
That slice is legit.
Yeah.
I mean, every slice here is legit, pretty much. You got the anchovy slice. It's funny, I used to be a waiter at a pizza spot. I used to steal the anchovies out of the
You like anchovy soup?
Yeah.
Yes! Finally! Finally!
Because good anchovies are not cheap.
Yeah.
So I was like...
Yeah.
Neapolitan stuff.
Dude, it's a treat if you come from like European descent. Like,
yeah.
You get anchovies, like everyone's like, yeah!
Yeah.
But people out here are like, anchovies,
anchovies are great.
Yeah. And then the turtles used to eat them all the time.
Anchovies, so good.
Anchovies and cheese is so
good. And the natural saltiness.
Yeah, you don't need all the extra shit.
Yeah. So my dad used to be a postman.
Yeah.
In Tustin.
Yeah.
He would go to his pizza joint all the time in Tustin when he's on his lunch break.
Yeah.
And order anchovy pizzas.
Yeah.
That's his go-to.
That's my dad used to order them too when I was little, and like nobody would eat it except
right?
I'd eat it because it's my dad, and I'm like, yeah, I want to eat that too.
So one day I go in there by myself, you know. I'm like probably like 16, 17. I got like the car. Yeah, I'm gonna go get some lunch. Go in there to this spot.
Yeah.
I go, yeah, can I get a slice of anchovy pizza, please? The owner looks at me like, I know your dad. I'm like, oh.
Is he like you the only person who ever orders?
Yeah.
That.
You know what he made me do? He's like, you go in the back and put it on yourself.
What?
So I went in the back of the kitchen. He puts out this big old can of anchovies. He goes, here you go.
That's
you put
sick.
It on.
Don't tell the health department.
Because he doesn't like, they don't like touching it. Like,
the anchovies.
You know,
that's
all,
the most Italian thing there is.
Yeah, but I don't think they're Italian. I think they're like Middle Eastern or something.
Anchovies are amazing. So many people don't like anchovies.
Right?
It's one of those things. It's like
true. Uneducated.
So good.
Wrapped around like those pickled chilies too, like they do in Spain, the tapas and stuff.
Sounds amazing.
It's great with beer.
Dude, that is a shit, really. It's good. So I went to this pizza parlor in the I spoke to him in a little bit of like broken Italian. He was like super impressed. He was like, cool. And they started hooking me up, started bringing like, all this shit, right? And he brings me this plate with like all this red, and I thought it was red pepper paste. I thought it was like green red pepper. So I was like, tight. So I'm putting it on bread, smashing it on my shit. It's fucking good. I'm like, what is this? He was like, oh, it's pickled.
Yes! I love pickled.
That's
creamy.
That shit.
It's good.
It was so
creamy.
Yeah, my chick was like,
oh, dude.
Dude, I'll eat any.
It's like butter.
I kept going. It was delicious.
I mean,
it was amazing.
Oh,
and
mean,
it was cooked like you know, like spicy. Like, it was good. And
it's creamy,
it the,
right?
Yeah. They cooked it in the ground. Like,
yeah. Okay. I went to Tahiti for like a skate thing.
What? Tahiti?
I had fermented.
That's a weird place.
People skate out there?
Yeah.
Like surfer joint,
bro. It was
like
a.
Let's go surfing,
it was like a French television show thing. And the last. Like after we were done skating the last day, they took us snorkeling, which was sick, and then they took us to have like traditional Polynesian meal that they cook in the ground, same, and it was like, but it was fermented fish head stews and all this. It was delicious.
Tasty,
like,
dude.
Yeah, it, like, it was amazing.
Probably a little stinky, but tastes
the other
good.
Dude I was with, the other skater I was with, he wouldn't eat anything.
Yeah.
Like he wouldn't eat anything. But he was like, he's like 18.
I'm down to try everything.
I'll eat anything. I don't care.
I'll try.
Yeah. I'll eat anything except for potato salad. That's like no potato salad.
You gotta try that shit.
No French's yellow mustard. That's, yeah.
So like, what's your background? Your family? Where'd your family come from?
Nebraska and Wisconsin.
Yeah.
So
just
yeah.
like American, straight American, or you got like some Creole in there?
I got some Native American,
Native
but
American?
I don't. I have a Irish great-grandfather.
So what'd your parents make for you? Huh. What'd your parents make for you for like meals when you're growing up?
So. Collard
greens? All right. So,
I mean, I had a standard American diet growing up, but then holiday food. Holiday food's a different thing. Like, for instance, I make a pot of gumbo every Thanksgiving, right? And then, like, I got that from my mom. Like, my mom would make gumbo every Thanksgiving. So I do that now. And, I mean, like, you know, like, whatever in a black American household would eat. Like, greens, cornbread, just like, stuff like that.
Oh, nice. Fried chicken, ribs.
We have fried chicken. Not too much, the ribs. Like, that wasn't...
Oh, can you eat pork growing up? That's right.
Yeah. We didn't eat pork in my house until, like... Until I was a teenager. Yeah, so yeah, no ribs, yeah. But I love ribs now. Yeah, I'll eat anything. I'm not.
What happened?
Just some hungry adventure.
Oh, we all are when we get older. We all are.
I just want to hit the gym all day every day.
That noise.
Yeah.
So what else have you been up to lately?
Skating, making some music.
I heard you have like a band or something.
Band? We played a show last weekend. We played like a grand opening of this motorcycle shop. It was fun. We hadn't played in a while.
What kind of music is it?
I don't know, so I just call it rock music. Because people bug me, right? Like when I was a kid, I liked punk music, right? So it's like, only listen to punk, nothing else. Punk and like hip hop, that's it. Anything else? Like when I was 16, like somebody's listening to the Rolling Stones, I was like, fuck that shit. Turn that shit off. It's like lame ass corporate rock. Like punk, like hip hop was okay because like hip hop was seen as subversive, right? Just like punk music was, right? So I turned 18 and I left all that shit behind, right? And like my family members are jazz musicians. Like my father, my grandfather, my uncle, they're all jazz musicians. Like so they're the same way about music, where it's like jazz music is the best and everything else is impure and it's
I feel on that.
By nature it's like subpar. My dad wasn't so much like that, like he listened to other things, but it like I feel like that's how people consume music. Less so today, but me being my age, my friends are my age, and the people I interact with mostly are my age, probably a little older. Mm-hmm. So you see people are kind of closed-minded. They want to, like, label everything, but, like when I make music, write a song, like, try not to constrict it to one genre.
Right,
like,
get influenced by all this stuff.
Yeah, because it's 2019, right? So, like, you, like, if you, like, whatever you're doing in 2019, you have the benefit of, you know, being alive at a time when so many different things have happened. Right. So it's pretty foolish to try to like limit the influences that you let get through. It's like, yeah, like, yeah. Like, I like, yeah.
Like what?
No, I was saying, I agree.
Yeah.
It's like, I have a rock band, but like, if I like a sound from a rap song, right, and I want to use a sound like that, why would I not use a sound like that, right? Or like, you see it a lot with like trap metal, like stuff like that.
Never heard of trap metal. Right. Trap metal.
Well, it's
whoa.
Like a lot of like hardcore and metal people make like rap, and it's got like heavy guitars and trap beats. And, like, it makes sense because it's 2019, right? Like, hip hop is 40 years old. You know, like rock music is however old it is.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, like that's a debate.
Just evolving,
so why
big.
Wouldn't those things cross, especially with the internet? Like, it's not like it was when we were young. Like, I used to catch a Greyhound bus to get to a show in the middle of nowhere to see a band, and like catch a train and a bus to go and buy a record of a band that I saw on the jacket of another band. You know, on a record that I had, and like that's the process you had to go through to acquire musical knowledge. But now it's just like, just type, yeah,
and you're there,
right there. Yeah. So if we're alive in a time where information is at our fingertips like that, like why wouldn't we incorporate all those different things that we have access to into whatever we do artistically, whether it's music or anything? You know, like I just feel like, so like I don't label my music because like.
Yeah.
Sometimes I'll be drunk at home and I will make a rap song. Come on, bro.
The car broken into. We must be in LA. Whose car is that? Thank you. Next.
Someone popped their head out up there at the salon.
They're probably in that Thai massage place.
We went to one of those once.
They wouldn't let him in.
They wouldn't let us in. Because she was there, and it was like a jerk spot. Like, and we didn't know. We're trying to get a massage, and we went on Yelp, and she found this place, and she's like, look how cheap this place is. And it's like, sick. We got in the car, we drive over, and we're walking up, and it's like all these little Korean dudes. And they're looking at her so funny. And I thought they were looking at me because it's like big black dude in this place, like, and then all these little Korean dudes. And then we get in, and I notice the woman who's working behind the counter, like, I'm like, yeah, I want to get massages. And the lady's just looking at her like, she's like, she's not allowed in here. And I was like, hey, girl, and then and there were women outside, like, smoking cigarettes and, like, talking to the dudes.
They were on break.
And then I put it all together in my head, and I'm like, oh, shit, we just came to the...
Damn, that's crazy.
So we laughed about it and went to another more expensive massage, unfortunately.
With more legit, though.
I guess. I mean, the most legit massages that you get are from, like, an old Chinese lady in Alhambra, you know, that's the spot. With like her arms are like as thick as my thigh, and she just gives it to you. Like you want to cry at first, and then you fall asleep. It's a process. You know what I mean? Wow, that's the best waitress ever.
She's bringing them.
Norman's about to be drunk.
Not as drunk as I was last night, but yeah, probably.
You got drunk that?
Well, we got a bottle of Stoli.
Oh, right.
And there's about this much left in that bottle of Stoli.
Fun times, huh?
Yeah. Went out to dinner with him. We had a shabu shabu.
Shabu shabu?
And Ayako, yeah. We had shabu shabu. And then we went to the drawing room.
Yeah,
it's
like the
It's also a blowjob. Shabu shabu is also a blowjob.
That's what it means?
Yeah.
That's what it means? No way! I never knew that! That's what that means in Japanese?
Yeah.
Shabu shabu means... It means blowjob in Japanese?
What the fuck? Why do they call it...
She's always telling me crazy shit about Japanese. Oh, wow. Like the Toyota Venza. A Venza is a fucking toilet seat.
Toilet seat on wheels?
So there's people driving around in a fucking toilet seat.
You think that their drivers have the bidet in there or something?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Shit, I wish.
I think they probably did that to
fuck with people.
Yeah. Fuck with Americans.
It's like the animators in all those Disney cartoons that would slip in random shit. Because you're designing cars, you're thinking of car names.
It's probably the biggest market.
And you're bored as fuck. Yeah. So you're like, you gotta abuse yourself.
Yeah, you're like, I'm gonna think of something funny right now. They're not gonna know. Till it's already made. Till it's too late.
It's like most trades have something like that. Like, what's that movie where. The guy is he writes obituaries. I know who the actor was. It was Clive Owen, I think. And he's talking about his job writing obituaries and how they use coded language amongst themselves just to have a laugh.
Oh,
so like
they
if
read
somebody,
it in the paper?
Yeah. So like if a guy was gay, they say he enjoyed his privacy. You know, like they use coded language, and that's how they communicate with each other to have a laugh. Most professions have something like that, like that they use to fuck with other people.
Right.
It's like the comical side of jargon. You know,
yeah.
I like finding shit like that.
Inside shit.
Just useless information. Useless information.
Nice.
Yeah.
So what's up? I heard you used to skate for Shorties too.
I got Shorties like, the first. I never made it into like a Shorties video or anything, but we skated at Hollywood High every day, and like it was serendipitous because like I was doing a trick on the ledge that landed right on the corner of Sunset and Orange. And Muska used to come by, and he'd come by all the time. We all knew him. he would like come by and he'd just buy us all cheeseburgers.
No,
what? Or he smoke everybody out at this place. Like Muska is the best. Muska is the best. Like
the downest dude ever.
That dude, like, so like he's skating by with his backpack, his headphones on, and I did like.
I remember he did a kickflip from 5-0, kickflip out.
Because he was there, yeah.
Muska was like,
Muska was skating, like, I didn't even know he was there, and he stopped. And he's like, he was like, yo, homie, you got a tape? And I was like, shit, I'll get a tape. Like, you know, and like, the dude like picked me up from my mom's job in the Muska lane. Took me to his house, watched the tape, and hooked me up with like all of his sponsors. And then like I got to kick it with him. Like took me to like a party on the roof of the ArcLight. Like I met like Pink and shit. Like I was trying to like bring my girlfriend to the party at the time. And he's like, nah, no, homie, you don't want to bring your girlfriend. I was like, I didn't even get it. I was 18 years old, 17, 18, something like that.
Don't be standing.
I was like, can I bring my girlfriend? And he's like, nah, no, homie, you don't want to bring your girlfriend. Like he's a beast. He's a true beast. And then I'm like skating a mini ramp with like Pink. She's got no shoes on.
Pink was
like,
skating too?
Somebody introduced me to Gwen Stefani.
Pink was like, skating?
Pink was skating the mini ramp barefoot.
Is the guy Mariana there too?
I don't even. Everybody was there. Like, it was insane. Like,
the slams everywhere.
Yeah, like, it was just legendary. Like, Muska. Muska. He's the best.
Wow.
He's the best. And I remember, like, Brayton Zafransky's turning pro party. Like, I hadn't seen him in a while. And he's, like, rolling up a spliff. I rarely smoke weed, but certain people, I'm not gonna refuse. I'm not gonna deny if they offer me. Like, so I was like, Muska, he's like, no, you want to smoke? And I was like, fuck yeah. And they're like, security guards are like, you can't do that in here. And he's like, yeah. Fuck you. And they're like, we just go to another corner and he just plays it like right in the middle of this art gallery. Like Muska is a legend.
No care in the world, huh?
He's the best. No care, but every care. Like there's no reason for him to do what he did for me.
Right.
He's just skating down the street. There's no reason for him to come and pick me up. Like most people who will hook up a kid, they're like, nah, you need to get to me. You know, like he's just the most down to earth person. And this is like around the time when he's like about to be in episodes of Entourage. And like, I remember one time I was on the phone.
Entourage.
With him. Yeah. He's in an episode of Entourage. Is that like a show?
I've never seen that show.
That's like a sitcom. Around that time, he's dating Paris Hilton. I remember having a phone conversation with him. He's like, oh yeah, I gotta give you my new number because my number got leaked in that Paris Hilton phone number thing. Like he's living that lifestyle. But he's coming and picking up some grungy little kid at my mom's job and taking me to his house. That gave me so much more self confidence.
I bet.
Like it's just like, oh, like I could be like a person in the world, you know, like if this person who, you know, like when the Shorties video came out, like that's when I started skating to fulfill the dream. Like I watched that video every day for nearly a year. Like that was like, it was like, watch Muska's part. Like, oh, like Muska made the music for his part. Like that dude did some, like I made the music for my last two skate parts. And like if Muska had made it, the music for his parts, like I would have never done that. You know what I mean? Like that dude.
Cheers to Muska.
Yeah, Muska, you hear that? Give me props, brother.
He's the best.
Yeah.
And then look, like now he's making art, like serious, sophisticated artwork, locked in a warehouse, making sculptures that are up for interpretation, like Muska.
Where's the pizza at?
Okay.
A bunch of shit.
Ooh, look at that.
Thank you.
Is that, what's that one called?
That's the Garibaldi.
That's the fresh mozzarella. Yeah.
And this is anchovies?
That's your anchovies. Did you get a fresh mozzarella?
Nope, that's you. Let me show the world what they can get in West Hollywood, California. This was called the Garibaldi, right?
Yeah.
Ooh, that looking yummy, dude. And this is Norman's right here. Let me see this.
Yeah.
This is Norma's go-to slice right here. There. Fresh mozzy.
Wow.
Dang.
I didn't realize how hungry I was until this came out.
Dude, look at all these slices coming out.
Oh, dang.
Where's Vito at?
Do you read me? He's coming out.
Vito, right? Come up and say hi.
Do you read me, right?
That was good too. What's that one?
Ready meat?
She's a meat lover or what?
Yeah,
you want to.
I always forget what's on there. So we got meatball.
I hope not too.
You got soup, bro.
Meat lover.
So we got the white slice back.
That's what Marcus got.
Wow.
Oh, he got the white slice. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
They have all the goodies here, like peppers and oregano and all that stuff. Oh, here comes Vito. What's up, Vito?
What's up?
How's it going? Is that for us?
Yeah.
Oh, I got the jalapeno and pepperoni one.
You got a good moment?
Yeah, Vito.
What's going on? Everything good?
Awesome. We're going to see how it tastes. It's my first time here.
Oh, come on. Can you never forget your first time, right?
I'm from Jersey.
Jersey's finest. From where?
I'm from Jersey. I was born in Hackensack.
Damn,
Hackensack. I live in Teaneck.
Yeah, let me get
I'm from Elizabeth. I'm from more of the hood, you know?
Word.
Nice. No,
it's
right.
Yeah, it's true. You had a scrap, man, to get through life.
Yep.
How did you come out here? What made you come out here?
What's the story,
Vito?
You
know? My brother is, an actor out here, and then every time I would come and visit, I say, yo, man, you guys need pizza.
No pizza.
There's no pizza.
Good pizza, right?
So he goes, why don't you make the... I was an auto mechanic.
Yeah.
Yeah. My father came from Italy. My mother and father, Alfa Romeo, brought him out. He was like a
crazy
hard ass, like, you know. Huh?
They worked Alfa Romeo?
My father did.
Wow, that's amazing.
And then he came out here that they were fixing, like, Alfa Romeos. And then, you know, he was a hard ass, but we're mechanics. Is my brother coming right now?
Oh, yeah.
That is your brother.
That's it.
Oh.
That's my brother.
Oh, yeah. I saw him eating in there earlier. Vito's brother in the house.
Does he got bother in the room?
So he made me come out.
Right.
He said, well, come out here. It's fucking cold. One day it was cold, right? He's like, fuck, man. He goes, come out here and make pizza. You don't ever have to work in the outside again.
Yeah.
He says, I never made pizza before.
It's the best pizza here.
It's a pain in the ass when it comes to pizza.
Yeah.
You know how to make pizza.
But not
one
only
day,
that.
He thought I was going to stay for the shift. I said, I'm going to show you today.
And
I left.
Yeah. Come on, stop fucking around. Where are you?
See you later.
Yeah. He's like, he's gone.
What kind of coffee you guys use?
Oh, here, Mario, you grab a bag for that. Sure they can have it. But then he's like, what are you doing right now? I could have pulled an engine. And he goes, all right, you're taking a friggin' 1,000 bolts and nuts out, and you gotta remember in your head, you don't think you can make a pizza? Because we would make pizza at home.
Uh-huh.
My mom died when we were kids. He was 10 months old, I was 2 years old.
Yeah.
And my grandmother made us cook with her.
Yeah.
You know, because, you know, chop up the garlic or whatever you need. You know, she's an old lady. And there was 5 of us. And she had 9 of her own kids.
What?
Whoa.
Yeah. So we were like freaking chopping up, thinking that, you know.
Whoa.
Yeah, it was cool. Well, you learned.
She had the factory going on right there.
Oh, she was so cool.
Wow.
She was the fucking coolest. Never a bad word to say. Tough. They're like, then why don't you get married? I was like, I'm trying to find a girl as tough as my grandma.
That's
beautiful. I never have to get married.
That's amazing.
Right on. All right,
let me get in there.
Right on, Vito. Thanks, Vito.
What a legend.
Yeah. First bite. A plus.
Right?
I love how it's like thin, but it's still got that little crust on there, you know?
It's perfect.
And a little crunch too. You know what? They know what's up with the anchovy. You only put the right amount.
Because you gotta have that ratio, right?
Right.
Yeah.
I've been in places like
where they just cover it in.
I'm like, what are you doing, dude?
Yeah.
Too much salt. They knew how to do this, just the right amount.
Exactly. You can't cover this at all.
No.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Oh,
what's
wow.
that?
It's for you?
What is that?
Thank you so much.
You ain't got no lady.
Thank
you
so much. Some coffee?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're so good. That's so sick.
Well, I got Vito's coffee.
That's so sick.
Did
I didn't
say
know
Vito's on there?
Yeah. Yeah. Looks like.
That's him when he was like.
Fucking badass.
So sick.
Let me see that.
Oh.
Vito's. Vito's big and bold.
Much needed because I drink so
Look
much
at him.
Coffee.
That's when he's like in his 20s or something. 100% organic French something dark. Dude, ultra micro.
It's so wild, right?
It's
to...
Beans, too.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You got a blender at home?
Yeah, yeah. Oh,
I'll do it.
Are you a coffee connoisseur?
I mean, I drink a lot of it. I'm not going to label myself like that, but...
I like coffee, too. I went to this coffee shop the other day in Old World in Huntington Beach. They had this tube, scientific glass tube thing going to another
siphon,
tube.
Yeah.
Going to another tube.
I almost
tube,
got one of those.
And I'm like,
we're looking at them.
Like, being in Old World, I'm like, this is like a German coffee thing, coffee filter? He's like, no, it's Japanese. So like, you know about it.
Yeah.
It's like a total intricate Japanese thing. Yeah, I was like, it was just dripping.
Yeah, we were looking at them together.
We're
both kind of crazy about it.
And
I mean,
it probably ain't cheap either.
For the past, I mean.
Fucking nerd.
Dude,
I don't drink this shit ever.
I grounded by hand for like four years.
I told you not to buy that thing.
For like 4 years, I grounded by hand.
I'm sitting.
Oh no.
Like with a crank, with a hand grinder.
Old school.
Because it doesn't heat up the beans and kill the enzymes.
You gotta get the burr grinder.
I have one now. Now I have the electric burr grinder, yeah. But for like 4 years, I grinded the shit by hand.
Good. If you use like a cheap grinder,
the heat in
the blades heat up because they're just made of like cheap metal.
Right, and then the motor in there.
And it burns the coffee and tastes like shit.
I thought about that.
If you get a burr grinder with a burr blade,
you guys are coffee like pros.
Nerds, bro.
Oh, we had to go on a coffee trip one day too. You know?
I have to have a subscription because.
A subscription to what?
For coffee.
What?
So, every 3 weeks I get sent two bags.
Are you do that?
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm kind of afraid to do it because I don't know. Like, when I run out, I might have to go buy some.
I set it up. You can set it up how you want. I set it up for
everything. I have this only in fucking Clearwater, Florida.
Yeah.
They have a coffee brand out there called Main Coffee, and he's been sending me coffee every 2 weeks. And all of a sudden,
I get two bags every 3 weeks. It's like $30.
Both of them doesn't know.
Oh, they do?
Yeah.
Well, what I use, you have like choices of, like, you can pick different.
What's up? So,
there's like these groceries.
You haven't like ran out
at
a time
or anything?
No. So they ask you like what kind of
coffee? No, we don't get here.
How much?
No. The best one, so.
It's
the
pretty.
One we have right now is from New York.
That's sick. Yeah. And then we'll do it.
New York coffee?
Mm-hmm. Because what would happen is, we drink so much, but you can't buy more than one or two bags at a time. And so you run out. Mm-hmm. And then the coffee that we want, you can only buy it from a few places.
Sometimes it's not in stock.
Lassen's is the closest place to us. I hate going in Lassen's. Also, they're closed on Sundays. And it just so happens that.
What time is LA City closed?
Six.
Oh, that's it. They're closing at six. But it's Sunday, so I don't know. Maybe.
Six.
He said it's at six.
Here, I'll give you the phone number, though.
Yeah, he said it's at six.
Yeah, you should call Dave, though.
You have a phone? Mm-hmm. Who are you talking to?
Antoine
Dixon?
Yeah.
What? So I'm True Skateboard Magazine said, what up?
Phil from True Skateboard Magazine said, what up?
He's like, I don't know no fool from True Skateboard
Magazine. He said, what up? Antoine Dixon, what?
Nah, he's chill. Yeah.
Right on.
A lot of cheese, I know. I'm like waiting.
Man, come down here and eat some za with us.
I haven't been here in a minute.
You know that za? Some za.
Yeah.
Just because this place doesn't close that early, but I always feel like it does. Mm. So whenever I want to come, it's usually a little later, and I'm like, oh, they're going to close. But I know they don't close that early.
Our time, midnight? Nope, it's a midnight. They are. Yeah.
I mean, it would I would imagine they might be open a little bit later, even because, I mean, it doesn't look like it right here, but this is a pretty heavy party area.
Oh, this street right here. There's a lot of stuff on this street right here. But this is La Cienega?
That'd be a missed opportunity.
Oh, yeah. You got the Beverly Center down the street right there? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I love Hollywood. Hey, thanks for sharing this place.
It's a good place.
I love this beach.
I try to share it with as many people as possible, man.
Dude, rather come here. Yeah. We go street skating or whatever up in LA, I'm going to come here.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Because I'm from the East Coast. It's hard to find good, like, New York style slice pizza. It's even hard. It's even difficult to find sliced pizza places.
Yeah.
Dude.
Yeah.
In Orange County, I'm like, you got slices? Like, no, mini pizza. Like, I don't want a mini pizza. I just want a slice. That's all I need.
I know. And you get that Detroit style pizza.
What's that mean?
That's like that Pizza Hut shit.
Oh,
that's Pizza Hut, Little Caesars. I believe it's Detroit style pizza.
Just full of grease.
Gross. Yeah, basically gross. Yeah.
Grease. Yeah. Mm.
I may be wrong, but I'm pretty sure it's Detroit style pizza.
I can see that. All right. So let's talk about the brand.
Yeah, the brand.
The Brujeria brand.
Brujeria skateboard.
What is that? What does that mean, Brujeria?
It means witchcraft. It's actually spelled Brujeria.
Brujeria.
But there's like a metal band that had that name. Argentinian metal band.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. They're like Sepultura, like that kind of vibe. So we changed one letter.
Kind of so you won't get sued?
No, not about getting sued. I think
SEO.
Exactly. SEO. Search engine optimization.
What's that?
Search engine optimization.
Oh,
yeah. Google shit.
Yeah, because you're not gonna find anything else Brujeria on the web. So
right.
There you go.
That was your idea or like?
No. That was an idea that happened before I was involved. Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah. The only reason I know is because I asked why it was Brujeria instead of Brujeria, which I mean, I don't think most Americans would know. So
unless you're doing witchcraft.
Yeah, it doesn't. Yeah.
You do witchcraft?
I mean, why not? I don't believe in anything, so why not do something that's not going to accomplish anything? Sure. I mean, I guess you could call skateboarding witchcraft.
Right.
Yeah,
like tricks.
I can remember a time when it seemed impossible, you know, it doesn't anymore, so.
Right on.
But, yeah, like, it's cool. We got a good, like, art direction. I like it.
And I heard you just came out with a video, I think, too, right?
You did just come out with a video. I believe it came out in November, something like that.
Yeah.
It took about a year to film it. Nice. Made all the music for it.
I made all the music for it. What instrument do you play?
Multiple.
No way. So you did like a little four-track thing and put it all together?
No. I wish I had one of those old four tracks. When I was young, I had one of those. I did it all on the computer.
Yeah. Oh, duh. We're in 2019. Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. I'm thinking... a lot of people still use those old four tracks. Like sometimes...
I'm thinking like 1990s still.
I'll search for them. Yeah, like the first Wu-Tang album was made on one of those.
Yeah.
That's what gave it that sound.
Yeah.
Gave it that sound.
Rawness.
I mean, I don't really believe in snake oil, so I'm not like a person who believes...
Snake oil?
Snake oil. Like, you know, people believe records sound better than CDs, which is complete garbage.
That's called snake oil?
It's called snake oil.
Oh, that's a
when
term?
When you're selling people bullshit, that's called snake oil. You know, like, I buy records because I bought them when I was a teenager and I thought it was cool.
Got turntables?
Yeah, I have a turntable, but I'm like going back and forth between selling it because it's stupid and just takes up space. Like, an adult in 2019, I got like a bunch of guitars.
Like, I don't need all that stuff. I don't need all here on this thing.
Yeah, I have everything on my phone. Sometimes I DJ, but I have no interest in doing that really.
Because you're a musician.
Yeah.
You play the real thing. You're not turning knobs, pretending you're turning knobs.
But when you DJ,
right?
The fucking thing about that is, when you DJ, you actually get paid better,
right?
When you play live music.
Is that messed up?
I mean, it is what it is.
It's weird, right?
It just is what it is.
It doesn't matter. You do both, so you chill.
Oh, dude, that's good. Do both.
You got cut out.
Oh, hey, Tommy. Yeah. If you need to, you don't need to. If you don't want, it's all good.
Thanks for coming, Scotty.
Hey, good to meet you, brother.
Yeah, let me bring you out real quick and then
say a problem. Alright. So, you got any, like, words of wisdom or last words you want to tell the world out here? about food or your life or...
Don't listen to people. And the only way that I've found any success in life is listening to myself. And it also be like when I'm an egotistical douchebag, like trying to learn as I get older that like, oh yeah, you're being a dick. Like you should not do that. But there's wow. there's no like script that you can follow. There's no book that has like wisdom that's gonna shepherd you through life or make you feel better. Also, people's idea of happiness is flawed.
Oh,
like
so
people
flawed.
Are always trying to find some type of happiness or like find this or find that.
So like, materialistic.
Just live now. Like that's why skateboarding is so amazing, because you have no choice but to experience what you're doing right now, or you're gonna break your fucking ankle. Like, you have no choice. Yeah. If your mind is on anything else,
nope, you're done.
You're gonna break your
you're
ankle.
Done. Yeah.
And that makes you be mindful. And I think that's the only thing that guides you through life. It's like, all right, I'm here right now. Like, whatever I read about, like, whatever fucking spiritual nonsense that I'm using to prop myself off and convince myself there's some meaning to me being on this rock, like, I got to cut that out and just, like, focus on not breaking my ankle right now. Like,
right.
You know, like, I think that's a beautiful thing. Or like music, you know, like music, like leaning into rhythm and boxes on a guitar.
Yeah.
Or a groove with a bass following a kick drum, or you know, like syncopation when you are playing drums, like like that type of shit. Like,
nice.
I think like I don't know, that's the only advice I could ever give anyone is like learn to do something that you want to learn to
that's
do.
That's good.
Lean into it.
Nice.
Yeah.
Well y'all hear that?
Be an individual.
Norman kicking down some of his knowledge.
So,
hey, if you're ever in, West Hollywood?
Yeah, I think.
Yeah, West Hollywood.
There's a bunch of locations, though, but this one, Vito's Pizza, awesome. New York-style pizza slices, for sure.
I was looking for you guys.
Good. Oh. Thanks, Norman, for sharing the spot.